Hi guys, this is part three of the custom Armored Core figure. My name is Donald Kennedy, aka Kodykoala. Now that we've got the ball joints smoothed out, like I showed in the last video, it is time to battle damage it. At least when I think of a major robot battle, first things to go for me would be straight edges, because, you know, you bang up against things, you're gonna, you know, people are gonna hit you with whatever weapon. So, you know, what I like to do is I'll get rid of most of my straight edges, or at least ding them up really good. So my favorite tool is the X-Acto knife. I'll go and take my straight edge and I'll actually dig, you know, deep grooves at random intervals and different depths to give it that worn out look. As you can see, I've already finished parts of the figure, so I mean, you can see that I've done quite a bit of damaging on this, and I mean, it looks like it's gone through a lot. Typical tools I like to use are obviously the X-Acto knife. I'll also use a straight cutter. This is to get through like thicker pieces of plastic, or say you have like this. See the flap right here? I like to use it to cut off, like, say if I want to cut off the tip, I'm just like snip and it comes off. And that way it's easier instead of trying to use the X-Acto knife. Another thing I like to use is, this is a wood carving tool. I actually use this to, like, I'm not sure if you're going to be able to see it on this, but you can see I've tried to do some really deep grooves into it just to give it that extra bit of damage, and that's what I used to do a lot of it. And finally, once the figure's got all its little nicks and cuts, I will go and take a straight file and scratch up the surface. Luckily, I use these ones because these are groove straight files. They have different kinds of files, diamond plated, blah, blah, blah. But I like to use the ones with the grooves because then when you run them across the figure, or you run them, they leave actual lines on your figure. So that way, when you're ready to paint and you actually dry brush, I usually do a silver dry brush, you see all the little scratches. So that's it. You just keep doing that to all your parts. See, I've already done it with the head, the upper torso, and one arm, and then one leg. You just basically get all the pieces damaged, and then once you do that, you're ready to paint.